Hi my dear student, today we will discuss exercise 1.2, third problem, second one. Find the inverse of the matrix by Gauss-Jordan method. Very simple. Let us take the given matrix as A, whose order is 3 by 3 in this case. Apply Gauss-Jordan method. We wanted to consider A matrix, respective identity matrix, I. Got it? Which is 3 by 3. Therefore, what is A? 1 minus 1, 0. 1, 0 minus 1. 6 minus 2 minus 3. The respective identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, the process is by using elementary operation, you wanted to bring this 3 by 3, this 3 by 3 as an identity matrix, and respectively what you are getting here, which is the inverse of A. Step 1. I need 1 here. So already 1 is there, no problem about the first row. Second row, I need 0 here, both are same, so I will subtract directly, R2 implies R2 minus R1, R2 implies R2 minus R1, because of same number, same sign. Here I have 6, I need 0 here, so R3 implies R3 minus 6 times R1, why? Same sign, so you want to subtract, I have 6 here, I have 1 here, so when you multiply by 6, it becomes 6, 6 minus 6 gives 0. So R2 minus R1, directly you can subtract. 1 minus 1, 0. 0 minus of minus 1, plus 1. Minus 1 minus 0, minus 1. 0 minus 1, minus 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 0 minus 0, 0. Next, R3 minus 6 times R1. So just multiply. 6 minus 6, 0. Minus 2, when you multiply minus 6, it will be plus 6. 6 minus 2, 4. This is 0, so minus 3. And this is 0, minus 6. This is 0, this is 0, so 0. This is 1, this is 0, so 1 only will come. So now I got zeros here and here. So 1, 0, 0. Now I wanted to bring 0 here by using R2. See what will happen. Leave the first row. Leave the second row. I wrote third row. I have 4 here, I have 1 here. Third row implies, see, between these two, both are same sign, I will subtract. I have 4 here, I have 1 here. When you multiply by 4 in the second row, it becomes 4. 4 minus 4, 0. So R3 minus 4 times R2. So what is R3 here? 0, 4, minus 3, minus 6, 0, 1. Okay, minus 4 times R2, minus 4 into 0, 0, minus 4 into 1, minus 4, minus 4 into minus 1, plus 4, again plus 4, minus 4 into 1, minus 4, and this is 0. When you simplify 0, 0, 1, and it will be minus 2, minus 4, 1. See, 0, 0, 1, minus 2, minus 4, 1. So almost 1, 0, 0 appear here and 0, 1 comes here, 1. So I need 0 here. When you add these two rows, R3 and R2, when you add these two rows, 0, no change, 1 plus 0, 1, no change, minus 1 plus 1 becomes 0. So in this step, I need 0 here, I'll add R2 plus R3. See, leave the first row as it is, 1 minus 1, 0, 1, double 0. Second row I wanted to do, R2 implies R2 plus R3, 0 plus 0, 0, 1 plus 0, 1, minus 1 plus 1, 0, minus 1 minus 2, minus 3, 1 minus 4, minus 3, 0 plus 1, 1. Leave the third row. 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. Minus 2, minus 4, 1. Minus 2, minus 4, 1. Okay, now I got 1, 0, 0. Here 0, here 1 is 0, 1, 1. So I need only 0 here. It will be very easy. When you add these two rows, 1 plus 0, 1. Minus 1 plus 1, 0. 0 plus 0. So it won't affect your existing 1 and 0. So what is the next step? I'll replace my R1 as R1 plus R2. When you go in this order, like 1, 0, 0, and 0 comes here, 1, 1, 0 here, when you go in this way, it will be very easy to find out the inverse. Don't get confused by bringing this identity matrix as it can be in any order. Why I am telling, when you follow this order, it will be very easy and comfortable. So now I am going to write my R1 as R1 plus R2. See what happened? 1 plus 0, 1, minus 1 plus 1, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 1 minus 3, minus 2, 0 minus 3, minus 3, 0 plus 1, 1. And leave the second row as it is, third row as it is. Okay, see? Split. So I am getting an identity matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So respectively, what you are getting, which is nothing but the inverse of A. So in this case, the inverse of A is, inverse of A is -2 -3 1 -3 -3 1 -2 -4 1. Is it clear? See, very simple. Let us take the given matrix as A, apply Gauss-Jordan method. Gauss-Jordan method is nothing but you want to construct a matrix which is nothing but A with the respective identity matrix. Now what do you want to do? By using elementary transformation, you want to make this 3 by 3 as an identity matrix by using elementary transformation. Respectively, what you are getting here, which is nothing but the inverse of A. So I used in order, very first I will bring 1 0 0 in the first column. Then I am making 1 0 here, then I am making 1 here and 0 here, finally here. When you go in this order, it will be very easy to work out the problem. Finally, what I am getting here, 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, which is an identity matrix. So this is nothing but your inverse of A. That's all.